Tidings of great joy. Only as we associate the Babe of Bethlehem with the Logos, by and through whom all things were made, do we get our mental focus respecting Jesus. His life was not from Adam, through Joseph, a forfeited life. It was a transferred life. The Logos, who was rich in spirit privileges, glory and honor, for our sakes became poor, the man Christ Jesus, that we by his poverty might become rich, that mankind might be redeemed from the curse, the death sentence, and all it includes of sorrow, pain, and alienation from God. A body hast thou prepared me for the suffering of death. The death of a spotless one was necessary as a ransom price for Adam and his race. No wonder the angels rejoiced to announce to the shepherds the Logos made flesh, the Babe of Bethlehem. Fear not, behold, we bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be unto all people. Few have analyzed the message. Few have seen how comprehensive its scope. It is for Jews and Gentiles, sinners all people. Only a few have yet had opportunity to get this great joy, but the Redeemer promises that he will yet be the true light to lighten every man that cometh into the world. For unto you, mankind, is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Ah, the meaning of that word, Savior. It means life-giver. The right to live had been lost. All are dying. The life-giver came to provide life everlasting for the dying race. Thank God for the life-giver, a great one, able to save unto the uttermost. The peace on earth, goodwill to men prophecy, has not yet been fulfilled, but it is nearing. The birth of the babe was one step toward it. The death on the cross was another. The glorious resurrection and ascension of the Logos again to the spirit plane were other steps. The selection of the church as Messiah's bride is another, nearly completed. The Messianic kingdom will complete the blessed prophecy.